Hello friends, welcome back to a series of lecture. I am Advocate Gaurav Singhadana and this is the 53rd lecture of this series of CRPC. So in the previous lecture we had left to the proviso and we had written some points on that. So let's again see it. Note down the points again, already note down in the previous lecture. As per to the proviso of section 200, there are two cases in which the judicial magistrate need not examine the complainant and his witnesses. Number one, where the complaint have been filed by a public servant or by a court while performing its official duties. The public servant can file a complaint in reference to section 172 till 188 of the IPC. Read with section 195, clause 1, clause A, sub clause A, CRPC. And the court can file a complaint in reference to section 193 till 229A. Ab sare section mein to hoga nahi complaint, whatever the sections in these apply. Read with 195, clause 1, sub clause B of the CRPC. And in the case of 193 IPC, it has to be read with section 340 CRPC as well. अब ये कई बार इंटरव्यू में पूछ लेते हैं, section 193 IPC false evidence है ना, so question ये पूछ लेते हैं, what sections of CRPC we club together? 195 clause B, 1 clause B होगा with section 340 CRPC false evidence में. Now in same point, next paragraph, in the above cases, the judicial magistrate is free not to examine the witnesses and complainant, though if he so desires, he can examine them. Now the second point is the cases where a judicial magistrate after taking cognizance, make over the case to other judicial magistrate under section 192 CRPC. He is free not to examine the complainant and the witnesses, though if he so desires, he can examine them. Next paragraph, the judicial magistrate to whom the making over has been made, is made, he shall examine the complainant, and witnesses if earlier judicial magistrate has not examined, them, but if the earlier judicial magistrate already examined, them, then he need not examine the complainant and witnesses. So in the next section, we will move to section 202 of CRPC. In 202, basically what happens after conducting the examination of section 200, and the public servant and court will not be examined in that, but the documents are to be seen. The magistrate has to make up his mind whether he has to issue process or he will dismiss the complaint. Agar issue of process karega to further proceedings honge, aur dismiss ho gaya to story is over. So the judicial magistrate has to make up his mind, but suppose if the judicial magistrate is having some doubts and is not in situation of making his mind properly, whether the judicial magistrate would issue process or not. So, usko doubt rehta hai ki main issue of process karun ya nahin. Means he is having some hitch. Then in that, in between, he could go for the proceedings of section 202. Agar judicial magistrate ne issue of process ka man bana liya, but usko thoda sa doubt hai, to wo issue of process ko postpone kar 202 ki proceedings karega. He will make sure for himself that he should issue of process or dismiss the complaint. So that is what 202. In 202, he could conduct inquiry himself. Agar inquiry karega to wo khud se karega, magistrate, or he can make an investigation done by the police officer or by a private individual. For example, he can ask for a lawyer also to do the investigation. Probably the magistrate would go for the police officer because they are trained for that. That inquiry or investigation that will be done, that is done under section 202. 200 mein kya tha? कि व्हेन इट इज अ केस ऑफ पब्लिक सर्वेंट एंड कोर्ट देन द मजिस्ट्रेट वुड नॉट एग्जामिन द पब्लिक सर्वेंट और कोर्ट ओनली द डॉक्यूमेंट्स टू बी एग्जामिन्ड बट इन अदर केसेस इफ एनी अदर केस देन द मजिस्ट्रेट हैज टू एग्जामिन द कंप्लेनेंट एंड विटनेसेस देन इन दैट द कंप्लेनेंट के डॉक्यूमेंट्स एंड द प्लस ओरल एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द कंप्लेनेंट ऑन ओथ एंड द विटनेसेस विच द कंप्लेनेंट प्रेजेंट्स The witnesses which present on the behest of the complainant, those witnesses will be examined on oath. But nothing more than that is done by the magistrate under section 200. In fact, summon bhi issue nahi kar sakta kisi witnesses ko under 200. Witnesses ko summon bhi issue nahi kar sakta under 200. Bas witnesses jo apni marzi se aayenge, usko examine karega magistrate. Ab maan lo एक कंप्लेनेंट आता है और वो कहता है कि मेरे पास तो कोई विटनेसेस नहीं है अभी इस टाइम मतलब उसके कहने से कोई नहीं आएगा देन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल हिज कंप्लेनेंट कंप्लेंट वुड बी टेकन द आंसर इज यस अगर कंप्लेंट अकेला भी है देन आल्सो द कंप्लेंट इज टू बी टेकन कॉग्निजेंस लेना ना लेना वो तो दैट इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग बट मजिस्ट्रेट एटलीस्ट अप्लाई हिज जुडिशियल माइंड ऑन द कंप्लेंट And if he takes cognizance and go for the 200 की proceedings, magistrate would examine the complainant. And if he need further examination, then in 202 he would conduct inquiry. और जब ये inquiry करेगा, जब magistrate inquiry करेगा, then he has power to issue summons to the other witnesses. Means सवाल ये उठता है ना कि inquiry क्या करेगा वो? जब सारे विटनेसेस को एग्जामिन कर ही चुका देन व्हाट विल ही इंक्वायर मजिस्ट्रेट मींस नाउ ही विल बी फ्री टू समन एनी विटनेस व्हिच ही बिलीव्स दैट विटनेस विल गो फॉर द फैक्ट्स ऑफ द केस सो 202 में ही कैन इशू समन्स टू गेट मोर विटनेसेस फॉर एग्जांपल मजिस्ट्रेट एग्जामिन अंडर सेक्शन 200 कंप्लेनेंट को एग्जामिन किया उसमें 10 विटनेसेस की लिस्ट लगाई गई complainant द्वारा and out of which 6 do not appear on the behest of the complainant court can always ask those 6 to appear under section 202 he can go to the spot he can talk to people there he can see the crime scene he can call more people to examine them he can track them so all that he can do in the inquiry Investigation में the police officer is authorized to investigate. Obviously he cannot arrest without warrant, but obviously he can go to the spot. He can talk to more people. He can collect their statements. अब वो statements 161 का नहीं होगा. Generally he will record the statements and any other photographs, whatever crime scene का photograph, site plan etc. He will prepare and present it to the magistrate. So that is a limited type of investigation that is not a full-fledged investigation magistrate would tell the police officer what exactly he has to do in the investigation and that is not covered by the chapter 12 but police officer ko kuch power honge 160 ka jaise ki 160 ka power hoga police officer pe to give notice and uske andar police officer could examine any person first call upon any person and then examine तो 160 का पावर होगा एंड अदर पावर्स लाइक 162, 161, 164, पुलिस रिपोर्ट 173, मिक्स डायरी 172, सो ऑल दैट पावर द पुलिस ऑफिसर हैव सो दिस इज द पर्पस ऑफ इन्वेस्टिगेशन एंड इंक्वायरी एंड इन दैट इन्वेस्टिगेशन एंड इंक्वायरी व्हाटएवर हैज बीन कंक्लूडेड ऑन दैट बेसिस मजिस्ट्रेट विल डिसाइड एदर टू इशू प्रोसेस और टू डिसमिस द कंप्लेंट So this is the background of section 202. Now read section 202. Any magistrate on receipt of a complaint of an offence of which he is authorized to take cognizance or which has been made over to him under section 192. On receipt of a complaint of an offence of which he is authorized to take cognizance or which has been made over to him under section 192 if he thinks fit and shall may if he thinks fit and shall in a case where the accused is residing at a place beyond the area in which he exercises his jurisdiction agar accused uske jurisdiction से बाहर रहता है, then it is written he shall, then he must do that inquiry or investigation, but otherwise he has discretion to do it or not to do it. फिर से पढ़ो इसको. Any magistrate on receipt of a complaint of an offence of which he is authorized to take cognizance or which has been made over to him under section 192. Some other magistrate made over or transfer the case to him under section 192 or the complaint has directly come to him and he is authorized to take cognizance. Obviously 202 would apply only after taking cognizance. Cognizance to wo le chuka, he already taken the cognizance. He had conducted 200, now he is in 202. Made over to him under section 192 may, if he thinks fit, and shall in a case where the accused is residing at a place beyond the area in which he exercises jurisdiction. Matlab uske jurisdiction mein agar accused rehta hai, then he may do it, but kisi aur jurisdiction mein agar accused rehta hai, then he shall do it. Residing at a place beyond the area in which he exercises jurisdiction, postpone the issue of causes. Means the magistrate under section 200 examined the complainant and witnesses and he has decided to issue process, but he has got some hitch. For that he would go under 202. First he will postpone the issue of process. Then he will go to section 202 and get an inquiry or investigation conducted. Postpone the issue of process against the accused and either inquire into the case himself. Agar inquiry karega to kisi aur magistrate se nahi karwayega. If he done inquiry, then inquiry has to be done by him personally. Inquire into the case himself or direct an investigation to be made by a police officer or by such other person as he thinks fit. Or direct an investigation to be made by a police officer or by such other person as he thinks fit for the purpose of deciding whether or not there is sufficient ground for proceedings. So either he himself will inquire or he will order an investigation by a police officer or by any other person. For what purpose? For the purpose of deciding whether it is a prima facie case, there is a prima facie case to proceed ahead in the case. Means whether to issue of process or not. Issue of process postpone karke jo inquiry investigation karwayega uska purpose hoga to see whether the issue of process would be done in the case or not. So write down something about clause 1. The judicial magistrate may, if he has some doubts relating to the issue of process after the proceedings of section 200 is over or postpone section 200 is over. After the proceedings of section 200 is over, comma, postpone the issue of process and either himself conduct an inquiry or order a police officer or a private individual to conduct an investigation. The purpose of such inquiry investigation is to find out whether there is sufficient material to take further proceedings. The purpose of such inquiry investigation is to find out whether there is sufficient material to take further proceedings. That is to issue process. Further proceedings is what? To issue of process in the case. If the accused resides within his jurisdiction, then such inquiry or investigation may be conducted. But if he resides beyond his jurisdiction, then such inquiry investigation shall be conducted. Now let's see the proviso of 202 and it is important one. Provided that no such direction for investigation shall be made where it appears to the magistrate that the offense complained of is triable exclusively by the court of session. Means court of session ke exclusively triable matter mein आप इन्वेस्टिगेशन नहीं कर सकते, तो वहां पर क्या करोगे आप? इंक्वायरी कर सकते हो. इफ द ऑफेंस इज एक्सक्लूसिवली ट्राइबल बाय द कोर्ट ऑफ सेशन, इन्वेस्टिगेशन विल नॉट बी ऑर्डर्ड, रेदर ओनली एन इंक्वायरी कुड बी कंडक्टेड एंड दैट टू बाय द magistrate himself. And the second one, where the complaint has not been made by a court, unless the complainant and the witnesses present, if any, have been examined on oath under section 200. Is prakar padhiye isko. Provided that no such direction for investigation shall be made, where the complaint has not been made by a court, unless the complainant and the witnesses present, if any, have been examined on oath under section 200. So, ye do clause samajhne hai, to pehle wale clause mein to koi pareshani hai nahi. Means if the case is exclusive tribal by the court of session, then no investigation could be directed. So, obviously there can be only inquiry. So, basically in proviso, there are restrictions are given of section of clause 1. Clause 1 restrictions proviso mein de rakhi hai. So, write it down. Section 202 clause 1 puts the following restrictions. So, for the first proviso, right, the court judicial magistrate cannot order investigation in those cases which are exclusively tribal by court of session. Thus, in such cases, the judicial magistrate can himself conduct an inquiry. Himself can conduct an inquiry. Now, see clause B. Where the complaint has not been made by a court. Now, section 200 mein yaad karo, that a complaint can be made by a private individual, can be made by a public servant, or can be made by a court also. If it is made by a private person, then 200 is the must. In these two cases, the section 200 is not must in this one, and is in this one 200 is not must. In 202, what they are saying is, if you want to investigate, if the magistrate under section 202 wants the case get investigated under 202, then he shall first get the proceedings of section 200. So general rule to ye hai na, complainant ko examine kiya nahi, aur complainant ka examine kiya nahi aur pehle investigation kara lo, to aisa nahi ho sakta. General rule ye hai, pehle aap ye ensure karo ki 200 ka examination hua hai ki nahi hua hai. अगर हो गया है तभी आप इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑर्डर कर सकते हो. अगर 200 का एग्जामिनेशन नहीं हुआ है और आप इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑर्डर करना चाहते हो, तो पहले 200 का एग्जामिनेशन कंप्लीट करो, देन यू गो फॉर द इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑर्डर फॉर द इन्वेस्टिगेशन. मींस व्हाट दे आर सेइंग इज, इफ यू वांट टू गो फॉर इन्वेस्टिगेशन, इफ द मजिस्ट्रेट इन 202 वांट्स टू गो फॉर द इन्वेस्टिगेशन, देन ही मस्ट एंश्योर दैट द प्रोसीडिंग्स ऑफ 200 इज ओवर. जहां तक प्राइवेट इंडिविजुअल का सवाल है, तो प्राइवेट इंडिविजुअल के केस में तो वैसे भी 200 सेक्शन 200 इज कंपलसरी. यू वुड कॉल इन द केस ऑफ प्राइवेट इंडिविजुअल, मींस इट वुड कॉल्ड प्राइवेट कंप्लेंट. इन द केस ऑफ प्राइवेट कंप्लेंट 200 इज कंपलसरी एंड मजिस्ट्रेट कुड नॉट गो 202 डायरेक्टली विदाउट एग्जामिनिंग द कंप्लेनेंट एंड हिज विटनेसेस डॉक्यूमेंट एटसेट्रा. सो ये जो प्रोविजो है बी वाला, इसके लिए तो लगेगा नहीं, क्योंकि ये तो वैसे भी कंपलसरी है, बिकॉज प्राइवेट कंप्लेंट एग्जामिनेशन इज एज इट इज मस्ट. नाउ इन द केस ऑफ पुलिस ऑफिसर इन सेक्शन 200, मे बी एग्जेम्प्टेड, मे नॉट बी कंडक्टेड, एग्जामिनेशन मे नॉट बी कंडक्टेड, एंड राइट अवे यू कैन गो टू सेक्शन 202. बट इफ इन 202 इफ यू वॉन्ट एन इन्वेस्टिगेशन टू बी डन, then before that you must be conducted the proceedings of 200. So the proviso will effectively apply with respect to the public servants. क्योंकि public servant का केस एक ऐसा केस है जहाँ पे आप 200 का examination करे बिना 202 में जा सकते हैं. लेकिन अगर 202 में investigation order करना चाहते हो, तो पहले वापस जाओ 200 में, public servant और उसके witnesses को examine करो, पब्लिक सर्वेंट और उसके विटनेसेस को एग्जामिन करो, देन यू विल गो फॉर 202. एज फार एज कोर्ट इज कंसर्न, देन इसको तो यहाँ पे इस प्रोवाइजो में क्लॉज बी में, प्रोवाइजो क्लॉज बी में भी हैज गॉट एक्सेप्शन. इफ यू रीड दैट दे आर क्लियरली सेइंग वेयर द कंप्लेंट हैज नॉट बीन मेड बाय कोर्ट, हैज नॉट बीन मेड बाय कोर्ट, हैज नॉट बीन मेड बाई अ कोर्ट, unless the complainant and the witness is present if any has been examined on oath under section 200. Complaint not made by court means what? Complaint made by a private individual or by a public servant. Then this proviso will apply. If the complaint is made by a court, then no need to apply this proviso. And therefore, court cases mein, court complaint cases mein, 200 ka examine kare bina bhi investigation order kar sakte hain. So, what we are saying is, agar private individual ne complaint kiya to 200 ka examination to waisi compulsory hai. To 200 ka examination kar gayi to 202 mein jayenge. When the magistrate decide to be conduct an investigation under 202, the examination of 200 is already be done in the case of private complaint. If it is not done, then you must ensure that it has to be done. By chance it has not done, the magistrate shall ensure that it has to be done. And then the magistrate would go for 202 proceedings. Public servant mein the 200 ka examination is not compulsory. So in the case of public servant, it may happen that without examining the complainant and witnesses, the magistrate may right away go to 202. But if in 202 he decides to go for investigation, then he will have to revert back. First he will have to examine the public servant and witnesses, and then only he will go for investigation. So that is what comes out from the proviso. That is what comes out from the proviso here. As far as the court is concerned, if the court has filed the complaint, then the 200 is not compulsory. And here in this proviso also, they are saying where the complaint has not been made by a court. Means what? Agar court ne complaint kiya tha, tab ye wala proviso nahi lagega. Court ne complaint nahi kiya tha, tab ye proviso lagega. Ab court ne complaint nahi kiya tha means what? Private individual ne kiya tha, private person ne kiya tha, ya fir public servant ne kiya tha. Therefore, agar court ne complaint kiya tha aur usme investigation karwana chahte ho, then without getting into 200, you can go for investigation. But not in the case of public servant and private individual. So, write down on clause 2, clause B. Clause 1 ke proviso B par. Write down on it. As per to the second proviso of clause 1. Clause 1 ka second proviso for this one. For this one, B. As per to the second proviso of clause 1, there can be three situations. Number 1, a private complaint was filed. A private complaint was filed as, in such a case, it is compulsory that examination under section 200 shall be done, and therefore a situation will not arise that the said examination was not done and the judicial magistrate decided to order investigation under section 202. So in such a case, if it is compulsory that the examination under section 200 shall be done, and therefore a situation will not arise, aisi situation arise hi nahi hogi, that the said examination was not done. Kaun sa wala examination? 200 wala examination not done, kyunki wo pehle se hi ho chuka. And the magistrate may decides to order investigation under section 202. So, usme phir directly judicial magistrate decide kar sakta to order investigation under 202. However, if for any reason such examination of complainant was not done, kisi bhi karanvash agar reh bhi jata hai, then the judicial magistrate shall first complete the examination and then only order the investigation. अगर किसी कारणवश भूल चुक बस अगर रह भी जाता है then the magistrate shall first complete the examination and then only order the investigation. Now the second situation is, if the complaint was filed by the public servant, then judicial magistrate is exempted from examination of section 200, and therefore the judicial magistrate may have got into section 202 without examining section 200. Proviso B of Section 200, Clause 1 will effectively apply in such a situation. So, judicial magistrate may have got into 202 without examining 200, Section 200. And proviso B of 202, Clause 1 will effectively apply in such a situation. First of all, judicial magistrate will have to conduct examination of public servant and witnesses under Section 200, and thereafter only he can get into the investigation under Section 202. Now the third situation is, if the complaint was made by a court, then the judicial magistrate is exempt from the examination of Section 200, and the second proviso nowhere binds the court to conduct the proceedings of Section 200 first, and therefore the court is free, court means judicial magistrate, and therefore the court is free to order investigation under Section 202 in such cases, which cases? Court complaint cases, without examining under Section 200. Now next is second clause. In an inquiry under subsection 1, the magistrate may, if he thinks fit, take evidence of witnesses on oath, provided that if it appears to the magistrate that the offense complained of is triable exclusively by the court of session, he shall call upon the complainant to produce all his witnesses and examine them on oath. Means ye kya keh rahe hain? In an inquiry under subsection 1, the magistrate may, if he thinks fit, take evidence of witnesses on oath. Now ye jo evidences and witnesses, so evidence or witnesses 200 mein bhi liya tha. Wahan pe they are using statement and here they are saying evidence. Then, but it does not make any difference. That does not matter. So, pehle statement bola, yahan pe evidence bola, uska koi difference nahi hai. So, 200 mein bhi to examine kiya witnesses ko, ab ye dobara keh rahe hain ki may examine on oath. So, here what they are talking about. So, ye main aapko pehle bata chuka hun. The witnesses present with the complainant, they are examined in Section 200. But there may be other witnesses also which are not present at the behest of the complainant. So those witnesses can be summoned by the court and they can be examined by the court in the process of inquiry under subsection 1. And if it is a case exclusively tribal by the court of session, then they are saying the magistrate must examine all witnesses. Now how does the court know and that who are the witnesses? Wo pata padegi, the complainant would file the list, uski list se pata padegi. Jo complainant list file karega, list of witnesses. Ab maan lo 20 witnesses ka naam complainant ne diya. Ab 5 to maan lo usme se appear ho gaye the usi samay. But 15 still are remaining. Now the 15 ko court would examine. If the case is exclusively tribal by the court of session. अब जरूरी नहीं है कि 15 का करे, अब 5 का अगर उसमें कर लिया था कंप्लेंट के टाइम पे कंप्लेनेंट के साथ, अब 15 में से 4-5 का एग्जामिन कर ले, बाकी क्यों ना करे, तो ये डिस्क्रिशन है मजिस्ट्रेट का, कोर्ट का, अगर ट्रायबल बाय जुडिशियल मजिस्ट्रेट, अगर जुडिशियल मजिस्ट्रेट के द्वारा ट्रायबल है मैटर, तो उधर जरूरी नहीं हो सबका एग्जामिनेशन करे, वो सेटिस्फाई हो जाता है उसी समय, अगर 3-4 के बाद, 3-4 को एग्जामिन करने के बाद कि भाई मेरे को अब इशू ऑफ प्रोसेस करना है या फिर डिसमिसल ऑफ कंप्लेंट करना है, तो वो वहां पे पूरे का एग्जामिन ना करे. बट इफ इट इज अ केस ऑफ, अगर केस है कोर्ट ऑफ सेशन का एक्सक्लूसिवली ट्राइबल, देन देयर इज कंपल्शन, ही शैल कॉल अपॉन कंप्लेंट टू प्रोड्यूस एंड ऑल हिज विटनेसेस एंड एग्जामिन देम ऑन ओथ. यहां पर कंपल्शन हो जाती है व्हेन इट इज एक्सक्लूसिवली ट्राइबल बाय कोर्ट ऑफ सेशन. अगर मान लो जुडिशियल मजिस्ट्रेट ने सारे विटनेसेस को एग्जामिन नहीं किया है कोर्ट ऑफ सेशन एक्सक्लूसिवली ट्राइबल केस में, तो एक्यूज्ड को जब इशू ऑफ प्रोसेस होगा ना, एक्यूज्ड के पास लिस्ट ऑफ डॉक्यूमेंट, लिस्ट ऑफ विटनेसेस भी होगा, कोर्ट विल गिव इट टू हिम, एंड इफ द एक्यूज्ड फाइंड दैट that all the witnesses has not been examined, as soon as possible the accused could raise an objection regarding such non-examination, and then the proceedings will stop. First, the magistrate will examine all the witnesses, and then only the proceedings will going on. So write down on clause 2. As per second clause, if the judicial magistrate decides to inquire the case, then he shall be free to examine the witnesses on oath. Some of these witnesses he may have already examined under section 200, and those who are remaining may be examined by him now. He may examine all or some of the remaining witnesses. However, if it is a court of sessions exclusively tribal case, then as per proviso 202 clause 2, the judicial magistrate shall examine all witnesses on oath, and for that purpose he may also issue summons. Write down a case, Rosie and another versus Kerala and another's 2000 Supreme Court. It was held that the objection shall be raised by the accused the moment you realize that all the witnesses have not been examined. He shall raise the objection as soon as possible at a later stage, particularly after the commencement of the trial. If he raises the objection, the defect will be considered to be curable irregularity. इसका क्या मतलब है? अगर शुरू में रेज करता है accused objection, then per se proceedings को stop करके, तो magistrate को कहा जाएगा पहले से तुम सारे witnesses को examine कर लो, तो फिर पहले failure of justice वगैरह को check नहीं करेंगे। लेकिन अगर trial start होने के बाद अगर आप objection raise करते हो, तो फिर there the court will not stop the proceedings. The court will require you to prove that because of that there is a failure of justice. और अगर आप failure of justice prove कर दोगे, then the proceedings will be seated under 465, and then the magistrate will require to examine all the witnesses. If you do not raise the objection immediately, it becomes curable. If the objection is raised immediately, it is per se an incurable irregularity. Incurable का मतलब the proceedings will stop, and thereafter the magistrate will first has to examine all the witnesses. And curable means the proceedings will not stop. First of all, you have to prove before the magistrate that there has been a failure of justice. If he proves it, then the proceedings will stop, and then the witnesses will be examined, and then the further proceedings will be taken. Curable का मतलब है कि failure of justice check किया जाएगा under 465. Incurable का मतलब है कि failure of justice का कोई test नहीं होगा, पर से हम मानेंगे कि it is a failure of justice. Now let's see the last clause of this section. If an investigation under subsection 1 is made, if an investigation under subsection 1 is made by a person not being a police officer, any private individual, a lawyer, persons, general persons, anyone, he shall have for that investigation all the powers conferred by this code on an officer in charge of a police station, except the power to arrest without warrant. So agar court ne police officer ko na kehkar kisi private vyakti se ya kisi se keh diya ki aap investigate karo, to us vyakti private vyakti ke paas bhi sare powers honge investigation ke. Waise chapter 12 ki baat to yahan par kar nahi rahe, तो चैप्टर 12 तो लगेगा नहीं इस इन्वेस्टिगेशन में, फिर भी व्हाट एवर पावर्स वी हैव गॉट टू एग्जामिन टू कॉल ए विटनेसेस एक्सेट्रा वुड बी हैविंग बाय द प्राइवेट पर्सन एक्सेप्टिंग द पावर ऑफ अरेस्ट विदाउट वारंट. सो दैट इज अबाउट फॉर प्राइवेट इंडिविजुअल्स. नाउ लेट्स सी सेक्शन 203. इफ आफ्टर कंसीडरिंग द स्टेटमेंट्स ऑन ओथ, इफ आफ्टर कंसीडरिंग द स्टेटमेंट्स ऑन ओथ, इफ एनी of the complainant and of witnesses and the result of inquiry or investigation, if any, the result of inquiry or investigation, if any, under section 202, the magistrate is of the opinion that there is no sufficient ground for proceeding, he shall dismiss the complaint, and in every such case he shall briefly record his reason for so doing. So in briefly he would record his reasons for doing so for dismissal. The complaint reasons to be recorded means the dismissal order should be a speaking order. मतलब आप 200 की प्रोसीडिंग्स कर लो, उसके बाद आपको अगर डायरेक्टली लगता है कि देयर इज नो सब्सटेंस इन द केस तो डायरेक्टली डिसमिस कर दो आप कंप्लेंट को, या फिर 200 के बाद 202 की प्रोसीडिंग्स कर लो एंड देन यू फाइंड दैट देयर इज नो सब्सटेंस देन डिसमिस द केस, डिसमिस द कंप्लेंट. बट इफ यू फाइंड दैट देयर इज सफिशियंट ग्राउंड देन व्हाट, देन यू वुड गो फॉर इशू ऑफ प्रोसेस. सो वी कैन से दैट first of all after 190 clause 1 clause a, then we would move to section 200, then after 200 either you can go directly to 204 or directly to 203, or if somewhere going to 202, then after 202 either go to 204 or go to 203, that is issue of process in 204 or dismissal. If find some material, then the issue of process, or not find any material, then go for dismissal. So complaint would be dismissed if there are no sufficient grounds, and the complaint would be, the issue of process would be done in the complaint if there are sufficient grounds. So the related topics to this is, what would be the remedy agar dismissal ho gaya aapke complaint ka, what would be the remedy? And other is, what are the grounds, good grounds of dismissal, and what grounds are not to be considered for dismissal. So write down, in section 203 a complaint may be dismissed either after the examination of section 200, or it may be dismissed after the examination of 200 as well as the proceedings of section 202. If the judicial magistrate is satisfied that there is no ground for taking further proceedings, there are some grounds which can be considered to be sufficient for a dismissal of complaint, and some grounds which are not sufficient for dismissal of a complaint. Now let's see what are the sufficient grounds for the dismissal of complaint. First one, if there is an undue and unexplained delay in filing the complaint. If there is an undue and unexplained delay in filing the complaint, on that ground the judicial magistrate can refuse to take cognizance also. And if taken the cognizance, then after taking cognizance he could dismiss the complaint. The second ground is, the dispute is of a purely civil nature. A dispute hamara purely civil nature ka hai, then will the criminal complaint is allowed in that? Agar civil nature ka koi dispute hai, तो क्या उसमें क्रिमिनल कंप्लेंट अलाउड होगी? अगर सिविल सूट, सिविल नेचर का है कोई डिस्प्यूट, तो गो फॉर द सूट. सो द यू कैन नॉट टेक द क्रिमिनल प्रोसीडिंग्स ऑफ द डिस्प्यूट्स व्हिच आर ऑफ प्योरली सिविल नेचर. अब मान लीजिए कोई प्रॉपर्टी डिस्प्यूट है, अब प्रॉपर्टी डिस्प्यूट में देयर समवन डिस्पोज्ड यू बट देयर इज नो क्राइम इन्वॉल्वड इन दैट, देन यू विल फाइल अ सूट. So no criminal complaint was maintainable in that. हालांकि criminal trespass वगैरह हो सकता है, but अगर कोई ऐसी situation आती है, civil, अदर कोई example है, pure family matter है, कोई partition का matter है, अब उसमें criminal complaint डाल दी, then it would not be allowed. Complaint proceedings would not allowed. Third one, if the complainant commits a default in making his appearance before the judicial magistrate, and he does not have any reasonable cause to make that default. Complainant जब आएगा तो magistrate साहब date of examination वगैरह 200 section 200 में fix करेंगे. अब magistrate ने कोई day fix कर दिया for examination and the complainant does not come in the court. Court ने फिर एक और date fix कर दिया, then also the complainant not came, and he does not having the reason why he is not appearing. So in such cases, if the complainant himself not interested, the complaint would be dismissed. हाँ, अगर नहीं आ पाया और next date में वो अगर आ जाता and he gives sufficient explanation that why he does not appear on the previous date, then in that case the complaint would be continued. अगर complainant नहीं आता तो पहली date में तो court dismiss नहीं करती है, he in the court would give the another date, and another date also he will not give any reason to not appearance and all that, then the court could dismiss. The next point is, the complaint is based upon some such document which is a privileged document and which cannot be produced into the court, and apart from that document there is no other evidence in the case. अब मान लीजिए जैसे हस्बैंड वाइफ के बीच का मैटर है, सपोज हस्बैंड से समथिंग सम राइट समथिंग, इट इज अ मैटर ऑफ बिटवीन हस्बैंड एंड वाइफ, इज प्रिविलेज कम्युनिकेशन. सो इफ अ मैटर इज ऑफ बिटवीन हस्बैंड एंड वाइफ एंड हस्बैंड कोट समथिंग, इफ द हस्बैंड कोट समथिंग एंड वाइफ कंप्लेंट अबाउट इट, एंड सपोज वाइफ इज नॉट हैविंग एनी अदर विटनेसेस, she is only having the dead document and it is in the custody of the husband, and wife gone to the for the complaint. So except the cases of in divorce cases वगैरह etc. उन cases को छोड़कर, so मान लीजिए matter था उसमें cruelty वगैरह का, some court वगैरह था उसमें, that is kind of cruelty and the matter is not of a divorce. तो उसमें divorce case में तो वो proof करेगी वो, that is different thing could be considered. बट अगर क्रिमिनल केस वाइफ बनाती है हस्बैंड के खिलाफ, देन इन दैट केस जब तक हस्बैंड परमिशन नहीं देगा वाइफ को, वाइफ इन दैट केस कैन नॉट प्रूव द डॉक्यूमेंट अंटिल द हस्बैंड गिव द कंसेंट, बिकॉज इट इज ए प्रिविलेज्ड कम्युनिकेशन. और अब वाइफ के पास उसके अलावा और कोई एविडेंस है नहीं, सो अल्टीमेटली देयर इज नो अदर एविडेंस, द कंप्लेंट वुड बी डिसमिस्ड. हाँ, इफ द हस्बैंड हैज डन समथिंग और सेड समथिंग टू द वाइफ which amounts to cruelty or which may result into divorce, then obviously in section 122 it was provided, 122 of Indian Evidence Act, that it can be proved. So here we are presuming that it is not related to divorce, cruelty etc. अब मान लीजिए कोई complaint based है किसी official communication पे, कोई एक complaint आती है official communication में, it is based on official communication and there is a privileged document, और आपके पास कोई other evidence नहीं है, तो उस केस में भी complaint dismiss हो सकता है. If there is no other evidence, no other sufficient ground to go ahead. Now let's see the insufficient grounds. What are the insufficient grounds on which the complaint cannot be dismissed? Means if a complaint is dismissed on this ground, then it would be considered that it is an insufficient ground. फर्स्ट वन, द एक्यूज्ड इज अननोन. अगर एक्यूज्ड अननोन है तब कंप्लेंट तो कर सकते हैं. हाँ, इशू ऑफ प्रोसेस करने में थोड़ी दिक्कत आएगी बिकॉज द एक्यूज्ड इज अननोन, बट कंप्लेंट तो कर सकते हैं. इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस द एक्यूज्ड इज अननोन. देर आर वेरियस केसेज इन विच द एक्यूज्ड इज अननोन, बट द कंप्लेंट कैन नॉट बी डिसमिस्ड ऑन दैट ग्राउंड. इन सच ए केस यू कैन ऑर्डर एन इन्वेस्टिगेशन. नॉर्मली अननोन पर्सन के खिलाफ तो कंप्लेंट लेते नहीं है, 156(3) में ऑर्डर कर देंगे इन्वेस्टिगेशन के लिए, लेट द पुलिस फाइंड द एक्यूज्ड. अगर कंप्लेंट ले भी लिया तो 202 में इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑर्डर कर देंगे टू फाइंड आउट द एक्यूज्ड. सिंपली बिकॉज द एक्यूज्ड इज नॉट नोन और नॉट नेम्ड, द कंप्लेंट कुड नॉट बी डिसमिस्ड. डिसमिसल ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट इशू ऑफ प्रोसेस मे रिजल्ट इन टू राइवलरी और फाइट और इल फीलिंग बिटवीन टू ग्रुप्स. अब एक ग्रुप ने दूसरे के ऊपर कंप्लेंट किया है और मजिस्ट्रेट इस वजह से खाली डिसमिस कर देता है कि अगर मैंने कंप्लेंट इशू ऑफ प्रोसेस कर दिया इसमें तो लड़ाई हो जाएगी, आपस में मारपीट हो जाएगी अगर किसी ग्रुप के ऊपर मैंने इशू ऑफ प्रोसेस कर दिया तो. सो इट इज नॉट ए लीगल कंसिडरेशन बिकॉज कोर्ट हैज टू डू इट्स जॉब, सो इट कुड नॉट बी अ ग्राउंड फॉर डिसमिसल ऑफ कंप्लेंट. नेक्स्ट थर्ड पॉइंट इज dismissal of the complaint on the ground that accused has denied the allegation. So it could not be a ground because accused तो अभी picture में ही नहीं होता है, locus standi ही नहीं है, accused तो कहीं है ही नहीं, आई नहीं, appear ही नहीं हो सकता. So write down, since the accused at the stage of complaint proceedings does not have a locus standi, therefore he will not be heard at that stage. There is no question of denial by the accused at that stage. Next ground is dismissal on the ground that the complainant have a bad motive. Complainant ke motive se koi farak nahi padta, अगर सब्सटेंस है तो इसी ऑफ प्रोसेस करोगे. सो कंप्लेनेंट के बैड मोटिव से कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, देयर शुड बी सब्सटेंस इन दैट कंप्लेंट. सो माई बैड मोटिव ऑफ द कंप्लेंट इज नो कंसिडरेशन. बट इफ द केस इज फॉल्स, मोटिव अपनी जगह है बट इफ द केस इज फॉल्स, अगर झूठा केस है देन इट कैन बी डिसमिस्ड. बट अगर केस सच्चा है, सफिशियंट ग्राउंड है इशू ऑफ प्रोसेस के लिए, सिर्फ इस वजह से कि मेरा मोटिव बैड है, द कंप्लेंट कैन नॉट बी डिसमिस्ड. इफ अदरवाइज देयर इज सफिशियंट ग्राउंड फॉर इशू ऑफ प्रोसेस एंड द मोटिव ऑफ द कंप्लेनेंट is proved to be bad, then that in itself cannot be a good ground for dismissing the complaint. Now in this grounds for dismissal of complaint, write the fifth point, sufficient ground for the dismissal of complaint. Fifth point is under section 203, 204 plus 204, for not submitting fees for serving summons. जो सम्मन वगैरह भेजने के लिए अगर फीस डिपॉजिट करनी होती है, अगर वो फीस नहीं देता कंप्लेनेंट, दैट कुड बी अ गुड ग्राउंड फॉर डिसमिसल ऑफ द कंप्लेंट. नाउ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज, अगर कंप्लेंट डिसमिस हो गया देन व्हाट आर द रेमेडीज. वन रेमेडी यू मस्ट नो, इफ द कंप्लेंट हैज बीन डिसमिस्ड, तो कंप्लेनेंट के पास क्या रेमेडी है. अगर मजिस्ट्रेट ने एक बार कंप्लेंट डिसमिस कर दिया देन ही कैन नॉट रिकॉल हिज ऑर्डर एंड एडमिट द कंप्लेंट अगेन, सो दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. द ओनली रेमेडी यू The one remedy you got is means complaint के dismissal के order के बाद review आप नहीं करा सकते. उसी magistrate के पास गए, application डाल दिया, please review your order, that is not possible. So we cannot ask the magistrate to take back the dismissal and review his order. But you can always go in revision in that to the High Court under section 401 and to the Court of Session under section 399. So you can do revision aap karwa sakte hain. If the High Court or Court of Session finds that the dismissal is on some absurd grounds, the dismissal order can be quashed. To ek to ye choice hai aapke paas. Dusra ye hai ki usi magistrate ke paas ya kisi aur magistrate ke paas aap second complaint kar sakte ho, unhi facts pe aapne dobara complaint kar diya. अब जनरली अगर हम देखें कि उसी मजिस्ट्रेट ने जिसने डिसमिसल करा उसी के ज्यूरिडिक्शन में है, अब दोबारा उसी के सामने कंप्लेंट प्रेजेंट कर दी और उसमें उसने उसी ऑफ प्रोसेस कर दिया, तो अब वो अपनी प्रॉपर्टी पे क्वेश्चन मार्क लगाएगा कि पहले मैंने गलत ऑर्डर कर दिया था, अब सही ऑर्डर किया है. सो फॉर द सेकेंड ऑप्शन एज अ जनरल रूल इट इज नॉट अलाउड एक्सेप्ट देयर इज सम एक्सेप्शनल केसेस. सो राइट डाउन, against the dismissal of complaint there can be a revision by High Court under section 401 and to the Court of Session under section 399. A review application cannot be filed to the same judicial magistrate for the purpose of recalling his order. Another remedy, a second complaint on the same facts in the same court, in the court of same or any other magistrate, in the same court or any other magistrate is inadmissible. However, it has been held that if the dismissal done on some absurd, unjust or malafide ground, then second complaint will be allowed. Similarly, if the judicial magistrate dismisses the complaint on a incomplete record or upon misunderstanding of the nature of complaint or without applying his judicial mind or by a non-speaking order, then a second complaint will be allowed in those situations. Similarly, if a new ground or fact is found and it is proved that fact could not have been known even with due diligence, then a second complaint shall be allowed. So write down some cases, name of some cases. Paramath Nath Talukdar versus Saroj Ranjan Satkar, 1962 Supreme Court. इसमें कहा गया था कि extraordinary situations ke alawa, conditions ke alawa, second complaint is not allowed. Next case is Mahesh Chand versus B. Janardhan Reddy 2003 Supreme Court. And the last case is Poonam Chand Jain versus Fazru 2004 Supreme Court. This one is important. Now the last topic is for this class, section 201. Section 201. If the complaint is made to a magistrate who is not competent to take cognizance. If the complaint is made to a magistrate who is not competent to take cognizance of the offense, he shall, if the complaint is in writing, return it for presentation to the proper court with an endorsement to that effect. Suppose if you are a judge and I come to you with a complaint and you find out that there is no competency to take complaint and it is a written complaint. Then in such a situation, you would direct me to the proper court with a written endorsement that filed before, that the complaint filed before me, but due to the lack of jurisdiction or cognizance, I am returning to the proper court. Yes, CPC mein hota hai na, return of plaint. Wahan pe return of plaint mein hearing hoti hai, par yahan pe aisa kuch nahi hoga. Yahan pe agar magistrate ko lagta hai ki bhai mera jurisdiction nahi hai cognizance lene ka, to aap seedha return kar doge isko. और दूसरा कह रहा है कि if the complaint is not in writing, direct the complainant to the proper court. Means अगर complaint writing में नहीं है, तो आप उसको orally भेज दो proper court के पास. और अगर writing में है, तो आप उसको endorse करके proper court के पास भेज दो. So this section is simple. But इसमें problem एक छोटा सा ये है कि will this section apply before taking cognizance or after taking cognizance? Because by now the magistrate is incompetent to taking cognizance in that case. So will I apply 201? Will the judicial magistrate apply 201 without taking cognizance or after taking cognizance? Now isme thodi controversy hai. Supreme Court ka judgment hai, wo kehta hai that this section would apply after taking cognizance. Kyunki kai baar judicial magistrate galti se cognizance le sakta hai. Ab koi vyakti laya uske paas complaint and he is not competent to take cognizance. But he has taken cognizance, but later on he realized that it is not his case. So in that he makes an endorsement and return that complaint because that magistrate was not competent and he took cognizance. So he make endorsement and send to the proper court. Or the magistrate knows earlier without taking cognizance lene se pehle isko pata pad jata hai, to udhar wo endorsement karke send it to the proper court. So it could be the situation of both before taking cognizance and after taking cognizance. Dono pe apply ho jayega ye section. But Supreme Court ka ek judgment hai, usme likha hai that it would apply, this section 201 would apply after taking cognizance. So case ka naam abhi hum dekh lete hain, but jo actual law hai is that it apply for both. Jo section 201 hai, it would apply before taking cognizance and after taking cognizance also. Write down a case on this. Tri-Sons Chemical Industry versus Rajesh Agrawal, 1999 Supreme Court. It was held that since section 201 is a part of the chapter in complaint, it will apply after the taking of cognizance by the judicial magistrate. So, वैसे तो post cognizance orders पे लगेगा, but pre cognizance order कहाँ pass करेगा? तो वो भी 201 में ही pass करेगा. So, write down. ये तो court ने कहा इधर तक, but this one also ये literal meaning, अगर meaning देखेंगे 201 के, then it would comes the meaning come out from this section. That, however, there can be a situation wherein the judicial magistrate may, without taking cognizance, return the complaint for presentation to the proper judicial magistrate. And such an order also, that is a pre-cognizance order, can be passed by the judicial magistrate under section 201 only. So that's it for this lecture. Thank you for watching.